Hello students, so now we are going to learn a very interesting concept of a Fourier series, which is very difficult for student to understand. But guys, don't worry, I'm going to make it very simple for you. And the name of that concept is half range series. So there are two types of half range series. One is half range cosine series and half range sine series. Now, what is this half range sine or half range cosine series? Now guys, generally what we have seen is the range for Fourier series is 0 to 2 pi or 0 to 2L. Similarly, we have range from minus pi to pi and minus L to L. Now, let's assume that in a function, let's say instead of giving range from minus pi to pi or minus L to L, they have given us the range from 0 to pi. So, it means they have defined or they have given us the function in the half range. Okay, so this complete range minus pi to pi is divided from 0 to pi and 0 to minus pi, such that the range is, the value of range is pi, or the value of range is L in case of minus L to L. So that time, that given function can be expanded in terms of only sines and only cosines, and that series is called as half range sine series or half range cosine series. So let's say if we expand that given function in terms of sines only, then it will be called as half range sine series. And if we expand that function as the cosine terms, then it is called as half range cosine series. So guys, this is what is the half range series. But conversely, if we observe the even and odd series, so we have done the even and odd function in minus L to L and minus pi to pi in the previous video. So if you observe that even and odd function, and if you analyze it, and if you analyze it using the half range definition, then you will get the half range cosine series and half range sine series. So let's start. So guys, for half range sine and cosine series, we'll be having the half range. So let's go back to the even and odd function. So in case of even function, we have seen that the value of a naught is given by the formula 1 upon L 0 to L f of x dx if we have range from negative L to L. And if the range is from minus pi to pi, it is 1 upon pi integration 0 to pi f of x dx. Similarly, an is given as 2 upon L integration 0 to L f of x cos of n pi x upon L dx. And the value of bn is 0. So we have seen these three formulae in even function, when f of x is even function, and for the range minus L to L. Now guys, if we imagine, that even function in 0 to L, and if we take its reflection over the y-axis, because we know that the even function is symmetric about y-axis, then we will get the value of function over the full range, that is minus L to L or minus pi to pi. And for that, I'll take one example. So let's say that there is one function, let's say it is defined between the value 0 to pi. So let's say it is defined by a straight line, and let's call this as f of x or y. So guys, this is what the function in 0 to pi. Now, if we take reflection of this with respect to y-axis, so its reflection will come on the other side. So it will look like this. That is, let's say, if I consider here negative pi, then it will look like this. Now, since this is periodic, what we'll get after this is, let's say here we have 2 pi. So here we will get this dotted line. Again, we will get dotted line here. We will get dotted line here again. So if we extend, extend this for pi to 2 pi or minus pi to minus 2 pi or 2 pi to 3 pi, 3 pi to 4 pi and so on, then we will get a triangular waveform. But guys, if you just consider this negative pi to pi, here the function is defined for 0 to pi and I have taken the reflection of this for 0 to minus pi. And by taking that reflection, we got the symmetric curve about the y-axis. And guys, this is nothing but the half-range cosine series. So in the half-range cosine series, we will be given a function in the half range, that is let's say from 0 to pi or 0 to L, and to get its value over the full range we have to take reflection about y-axis. But in the numericals, what we are gonna do is we are gonna use the formula of even function, because as per the even function we will get a naught an, and these values we will be using to find out the half range cosine series. So half range cosine series, that is f of x, is given by the formula a naught plus summation n equals to 1 to infinity an cos of n pi x by l if we are finding it for 0 to l. So guys, just remember that in case of half range series, your range will be always half range, that is either 0 to l or 0 to pi. So this formula we'll be using, and if it is 0 to pi, we will just replace this x with pi, this l with pi, pi and pi will be cancelled, we'll get cos nx. So that formula we will use in case of half range cosine series in 0 to pi. Now let's move to half range sine series. Now to understand half range sine series, what we'll do is we will take one function in 0 to pi or 0 to l, and we will take its reflection in the opposite quadrant, because we get half range sine series if the function is odd. So guys, if you analyze it from the even and odd function perspective, then if f of x is odd, you generally get a naught as 0, you get an as 0, and you get value of bn as 2 by l integration 0 to l f of x sine of n pi x upon l dx. So we just get the value of bn, or we get the Fourier series in terms of sine. So only sine terms we get. Now if I analyze this f of x, which is an odd function, such that it is defined in a range 0 to pi or 0 to l like this. So here I'll show you. So let's say here we have pi, here we have 2 pi. So this is x and this is the value of function, that is f of x. And let's say here I'm defining that function by straight line which I used in the previous diagram. Now this function is defined in 0 to pi. Now I'll take its reflection in the opposite quadrant, because generally the odd functions, all odd functions are symmetric in opposite quadrant. So you can say like x cube, x raised to 5, x, they all are odd function, and odd functions are symmetric about opposite quadrant. So this is the quadrant number 1. So we will have curve in the quadrant number 3. So I'll show it by dotted line. Now this is reflection. If I take a curve for this line, or if I say it is periodic, then I'll get curve like this. I'll get curve like this. So we will get parallel straight lines. So guys, here I'm taking curve between 0 to pi, and I'm taking reflection in 0 to minus pi in the opposite quadrant. So this is the odd graph, and here we can use the half range sine series. So in half range sine series, we will be having range 0 to l or 0 to pi, and we'll be finding f of x by using this formula. Thank you.